Samsung's Galaxy Buds team has blown us away with their wireless earbud design. There was a time not too long ago we didn't think any wireless earbuds would be repairable. Samsung has proven that's not only possible, but they make it look easy and they don't even bother mentioning it as a selling point. Because of that, each new pair of Galaxy Buds that comes out piques our interest. The latest, the Buds Pro, especially calls our attention. Will this be the pair that ends the Galaxy Buds repairable streak? Or, like the Buds Live before them, will they set a new record for bud repairability? Let's find out. Like all the Buds before them, these ones crack under pressure from a vise. Well, sort of. The pressure temporarily deforms the buds to break the adhesive seal and allows you to get an opening pick inside. Next, you work the pick around the bud to separate the two halves, then disconnect this nice ribbon cable connecting them. In the top half, a tiny circuit board is held down by a Phillips screw. So far, so good. On the first side of that board are a pair of microphones and some chips. Then the reverse side reveals a Samsung package, a first that I can remember in a pair of Galaxy Buds. The rest of the tech is crammed into the bottom half of the bud. Here you can make out the silver battery under this connector board and cable. Those are lightly adhered down and come up with some spudgering, but that's the end of the good stuff. In a first for the Galaxy Buds family, this button cell battery is not easily removable for a replacement in the future. It does pop out of the housing without a fuss, but where previous buds have used contact pins to suck battery juice, this battery is soldered to these cables on its side. Under the battery, a plastic liner hides all the driver hardware. But like the first Galaxy Buds and Buds Plus, that's just a bucket of glue. Some behind-the-scenes soldering gets us a good look at the battery and reveals another first. This is the first pair of buds I've seen with a custom Samsung battery. It's a tiny 0.22 watt-hour cell. That's the same as the old Varta cells, but this one is slightly more compact. Well, that was a bit of a letdown. I wasn't expecting these to be as good as the Galaxy Buds Live, but I was expecting better than this. In all of the other Galaxy Buds, the battery isn't soldered to anything, so you can replace it in a few years when it dies. Let's see if this charging case is any better. Usually to open a Buds case, you just need to stick an opening pick into the seam at the front of the case like this. Oh, that worked. Next, I'll use a spudger to finish separating the clips holding this together, and then it comes right apart. Underneath, a plastic shell housing what I'm guessing is the battery. Some screws hold that down, and then three clips hold it together. And that is the battery. It's a 1.81 watt-hour cell, and it connects to the circuit board under it with these convenient contact pads. Finally, a few more screws hold down the circuit board. It comes up with the wireless charging coil in tow. And that's the end of the line. So the Galaxy Buds Pro are an interesting mixed bag. For some reason, the Buds batteries are no longer easy to replace. Whether that's for waterproofing, that new battery from Samsung, or maybe a new design team, I'm not sure. The case, on the other hand, is easier than ever to work with. Unfortunately, that isn't the battery I'm most concerned about replacing. The Galaxy Buds Pro earn a 3 out of 10 on our repairability scale. Their design makes a few concessions to repair, mostly in the charging case, but they are sadly a big departure from their repairable predecessors.